There's a modal that says, how would you like to start? And then there's two options, upload or send for signature. And then the second one to the right is create document using templates. And when, you know, when somebody's already selects create document with templates, you're presented with a few templates here, like NDA templates and invoice and proposal templates. Can you talk a little bit about like the journey with templates? Because like it's something that I know Lala and I, the AppQ's team, like the whole AppQ's team is working on to create templates. But you said this was new. Like, is it newish? How did this come?
The first part is kind of newish. It's definitely newer than the gallery that you show the next one. So the first part, yeah, like during the research, we found out that the first few things that people want to jump into is either just upload their own document, and that's the first option. The second one is create a document using a template, and we just offer them, hey, we have a template gallery for you to just jumpstart your journey with PandaDoc. And we have these templates set up with all of the things that you need and all of the design that you might like. And we have a lot of them for you to pick from. So the next screen where you see different templates, we just try to cater to different teams. Is it a sales team, or like maybe it's a sales manager that evaluating PandaDoc so they can check out the proposal or a quote? And surely the proposals are the most beautiful, because they have on the cover page with a nice design, and there's a little other thing design wise, and they have a pricing table and they have some sample products, so you can just quickly just plug and play with that template. But we also have agreements if it's a more like, I don't know, HR or legal team too.
It's interesting to me that like the fanciest design one is the most, like, one of the most popular. I don't know why that surprises me, but sometimes it does. I feel like sometimes people are like intimidated by fancier stuff and they just kind of click the most basic thing. But I love that, like, your audience, I think, is like, no, we like this pretty thing because your things are so pretty. So it just makes sense to me. But like, I feel like a lot of the times, at least myself, when I start off with a template, I'm like looking for like the, unless it's like a website or something, but I'm looking for the most, like, not basic one, but like the one that is most tailored to my needs, or the one that like I'm not really looking at design. So I love that this like catches the eye, especially when you're looking at it on the screen. It's like there's some really pretty gradients and shapes and blues that catch your eye. So that's really cool. I bet it makes it clear, even if you weren't sure if you were going to choose a template.
And that's where we have different categories on the left side. So like if you want to find something specific to cater your needs, like you said, you can choose from a specific industry that you work in, or like specific type of document, like quote or proposal or agreement. And then you can decide if you want to go fancy with the design, because not all companies have a dedicated design team to create their own like proposal design. And yeah, that's a good way for them to start with something. And plus, we have that community gallery that's right, underfeatured there, and it's like actually the companies that kind of donated their templates and their design. Yeah, so kind of a real life example, if you will.
Sorry. My dogs are making an appearance in the background, maybe. But they want to be involved in everything that I do.
Yeah, they want to chime in on templates.
Dogs get excited. It's like squirrels for them.
Yeah, squirrels or butterflies. Gryffindor and his butterflies. I was wondering, like, throughout this and setting up, and when you were setting this up, if there were any insights you saw, like, I guess the design thing sort of surprised me, but, you know, are there anything that surprised you in looking and setting up this, making some of these updates and the information that you got so far?
Well, the biggest insight is that users like to start with something. They don't want to start with a blank document. So that's why the whole idea of the template gallery is. So if, if we show them the template gallery, this choice of different templates, they are more likely to like interact with the application more.
Super yeah. Yeah, it makes a ton of sense. I think that's the direction that, you know, the top PLG companies are going, really trying to get things as easy as possible to start up. So it makes a ton of sense to me.
I noticed myself when I'm evaluating, I love evaluating different like task management apps and I don't know, you know, like efficiency apps. And when I'm evaluating them, I love like seeing sample content, like sample, I don't know if it's sample task. And if it's filled up with some features and like things that are relevant to a task, I don't know, maybe a deadline, maybe some like subtasks, is just awesome because that's how you discover features. You don't have to like go look for them. Oh, do they have the deadline? Or do they have some kind of subtask or functionality? No, it's right there. So the same with our template gallery.
Yeah.